This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Hell Show.
Today is December 24th. It's Christmas Eve.
I know, that's what I was going to say, but I couldn't remember what it was. It's been a long day. We're actually filming this...
Actually, it's the day before. It's the eve of Christmas Eve.
The eve of Christmas Eve. We're filming this the day before because we have to be traveling tomorrow. Mm-hmm. But anyway...
Merry Christmas, those of you that celebrate Christmas.
Happy Hanukkah. Mm-hmm. Happy Ramadan. Is that what... I don't know what to say. If you celebrate that, please tell us what you say. I would like to know. Mm-hmm. And we're going to show you a recipe that we're taking with us...
Yay!
...to Christmas.
One of them.
Yeah, there's a few others.
Yeah. It's going to be a late night, but that's okay.
Yeah, it's going to be a late night, because I'm going to be editing this, and Amory's going to be making the meal. So, because I am a disaster at this sort of stuff. So let's get into it.
Yeah, the camera really close to me again.
Sorry.
That's okay. Stop.
How about that?
No, like an arm distance away.
That was an arm distance. That was a really short 2-year-old's arm.
I am making a yummy, yummy, hearty chili, raw chili. I have a couple recipes for raw chili. This one is without sprouts. That's like a giant arm distance away.
I don't understand this chili without sprouts. What is this all about?
Well, because I have another recipe that I'll do probably in January or February.
Like sprouts like these?
No, not those sprouts.
Not these?
Mm-mm. Oh. Like grain sprouts.
Sprouted grains.
Yeah, like barley and buckwheat, even though buckwheat's not a grain, but buckwheat sprouts.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to do that recipe in like January or February.
Okay.
But this one is just all veggies. It's going to be very yummy. All
right. What do we got?
We have carrots and mushrooms and garlic and zucchini. Mm-hmm. And we have raw eggplant.
Whoa, people have been asking about a raw eggplant recipe.
I'm not crazy about raw eggplant.
But I'm not either.
The way this is going to be marinated, it's going to be pretty yummy.
Okay.
So we'll get into it.
So let's do it.
Okay.
We're running out of time already.
Oh, God. Raw eggplant. Tomatoes.
Uh-huh. Yum. Oh, look at that spoon. Did you show that yet?
I think I did. This is my heart spoon.
Oh, it's cute.
It's very close to my heart.
Right now it is.
It's a great way to add more love to your food.
Mm-hmm.
And zucchini. And I have yellow zucchini too.
Okay.
Yellow squash. Uh-oh, my bowl might not be big enough. Red onions.
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually doubling the recipe, but I'm going to leave you guys with the...
Because hopefully we'll be able to introduce this to some of our family members.
Yeah. Some portobello mushrooms chopped up just a little.
Uh-huh.
Carrots.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Oh, we'll be fine.
Oh, boy.
Remember garlic. Remember the last time I said we'll be fine, yeah.
Lots and lots of garlic.
Uh-huh.
All right. So we're going to actually marinate our vegetables... And garlic.
Look at that.
Some lemon juice.
Mm-hmm.
And olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to salt them. We're going to put about 3 tablespoons.
Whoa.
Of salt. We're actually going to let these sit overnight.
Okay.
I'm going to show you a little thing. Now, let's mix this in my small bowl.
Oh, this is going to be tough.
I was using the bigger bowl for the salad for tomorrow.
Well, I have the big bowl in the other room that I...
Oh, you have the really big bowl.
Yeah, for my salad.
That actually should be used for the salad tomorrow. Well, I'm going to show you guys how we're going to press this. Now, there is a tool.
Press it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There is a tool called like a salad press.
Like just like... press it?
Yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm going to press this down as much as I can go, and then every few hours we're going to leave it in the fridge, and then every few hours I'm going to press it even more.
Okay.
And it's just a neat way to marinate the vegetables, but there is an actual gadget that does this. It's called a salad press.
Like a crank or something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, there is a crank on it, yep.
Okay.
But we don't have one here, so... And as it marinates in the oil and the lemon juice, obviously the vegetables are going to get softer. I'm going to put this in the fridge,
uh-huh.
and we will press it again in a little bit.
Cool.
Now for our sauce. Tomatoes, regular tomatoes, and then I had sun-dried tomatoes. The ones that I have were soaked in olive oil. Here's some water.
How much?
And a little bit more olive oil. Water was approximately a cup and a half, but we're going to do it to consistency. So I'm going to blend this up first.
No salt or anything?
Well, I'm going to add the spices after. I'm going to blend this first, and then I'll add I'll add all the spices. So, let's blend. Smells great. All right. I'm going to add some spices. I'm going to add some cumin. I'm going to add some celery seeds. Some cayenne. Just a little pinch of cayenne.
Yeah, that's a good pinch.
Some oregano. And you guys can play with the spices to depending on what you like to add in your chili. Chili powder. And I'm going to add a little bit of cinnamon.
Ooh. Some people put chocolate in their chili.
Yeah, chocolate and we've got a lot of different things.
We're not going to be putting any chocolate in the chili, but...
You can put cloves in there.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just going to mix this up real quick. Cool. And I'm going to give it a taste. It's good.
Cool.
Very good. Probably want it, I might even thin that out a little bit. But what I'm going to do is right before I put it back in with the veggies, I'm going to add a little bit more water in it to thin it out a little bit. Just real quick, blend a little bit more water, then pour it on top of the veggies and mix it up and we'll have our chili.
Great.
Okay, we're back. We have our marinated vegetables that we were pressing occasionally overnight last night.
Uh-huh. I can't believe how much liquid.
Yeah, look at that.
Comes out. These are just, they're like pressed.
Yeah. and the veggies are really, really soft. The carrots are still a little hard, but the veggies, the other ones are really soft. So uh-huh. it's kind of like we sauteed them or cooked them.
Cool.
So I'm just going to take a little because I'm not going to, we're going to be traveling today, so I'm not going to put it all together. I'm just going to take a little in this bowl, add a little sauce to it.
And now, would we mix it together, like, totally, if we were, like, preparing this, or is it something that you kind of, like...
Yeah, I'm okay. Going to mix it together totally.
Gotcha.
Probably in that bowl, so...
Later today,
gotcha. So it looks more like a chili.
Well, there you go.
It
looks like chili. Look, even around like the edge of the bowl, it's all messy.
Yeah.
So here we are. We have a meal now that we can go and we can take to a holiday party and not have to worry about, you know, kind of figuring out what the meal is. The only thing that we have to worry about is that too many people will enjoy this and we won't be able to eat.
Yeah, I think so.
That's what happened last year with Anne-Marie's kale salad. Literally, like...
Everyone's, like, indulging on it. And that, we're like,
What about us? This is what we brought for us.
This is the only thing we can eat. But that's a good thing.
That's a good thing. So your question of the day is, what are you preparing for the holidays? We'd love to know. Go ahead and post it down below. Or what's your family preparing if you're not preparing anything personally? Or what is the restaurant that you're going to preparing? Or... Oh, who knows? Something else. If you're not celebrating the holidays, what are you eating for dinner tonight? Or what did you eat for dinner? Should I stop?
No, you can stop now.
Okay. This is Kevin Gianni and...
Anne-Marie Gianni.
We want to wish you a very, very happy holidays.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't even wear Santa's hats. We should have worn Santa's hats.
We should have worn Santa's hats.